First, I knew China as a volunteer. I do lots of volunteer work in the community, mostly with children and through the arts. And China started volunteering with me a couple of years ago at Kids Day in Bienville.
China has always been a standout with anything that she does. If I ever gave an assignment, first to turn it in, the best one usually. When the rest of the class was being crazy on a Friday afternoon, China was always doing what she was supposed to be doing.
Most people have no idea the adversities that she's faced because she doesn't advertise them, and you just wouldn't know. The mother has been very sickly and unemployed for several years. The situation was bad enough as it was, and from what I understand, they were living in a trailer when the trailer caught on fire. Then they were, I think, given another trailer that had some problems, so they had to fix it up. And just as they were ready to move into the new trailer, that's when Katrina hit and took everything. She doesn't have any pictures of herself at all, except for the last year.
We actually had a friend said that we could come and live with him. It was pretty nice because we weren't used to that. You know, we had always lived in a small trailer with a bunch of people. We had a two-bedroom trailer with 12 people.
I think the difference between her and a lot of other students is that many of them want to use as an excuse to not do something, and she uses everything that she's been through as her reason to do what she should.
I never had anyone to look up to. It was always my own self-discipline, my own thoughts that made me do well in everything I did. And so I also tried really hard for my little brother.
She stands out as an example for other students about the kind of person you should strive to be.
When she's in there with me and my students start to talk a little bit or, you know, start to complain or something, she's usually quicker than I am to say, it's not as difficult as you're making it. She sees them trying to make an excuse and she's very quick to stop.
She's just real inspirational to the kids around here, and her biggest thing to me is just how easily she gets others involved.
Through the National Honor Society, she has helped with some volunteer work. She's volunteering with the Red Cross. Right now we're collecting stuffed toys and stuffed animals for the Penelope House.
We have very few students who do every volunteer activity like China does. We have lots of kids who do one or two things or just the volunteer activities that kind of have perks with them, and China does all of them. It's just amazing because usually with high school kids it's kind of hard to say, yeah, come work for free. Go ahead, come work for free. And yet she recruits people.
I see her as a hero because of the example she is for other students. And I see her as a hero who will succeed in her future life and continue to be a good example.
If we had a lot more students who would have that kind of attitude, then, you know, hero doesn't have to be somebody who just saved a life. Just being a good person and being a good role model to show other people that, you know, there are other routes to take and there are other decisions that you can make.
I think it's awesome to be called a young hero, but I don't really think of myself as a young hero because I'm just like every other student. I'm just trying the best I can, and I'm just lucky enough to have been noticed for the hard work that I've done.